Hi, I'm George with Epiphan Video, and today we wanted to look at quick setups on Pearl 2. We're going to walk you through the initial networking setup and then some of the very basics to get you started. So let's jump into it. When we first take Pearl 2 out of the box, we need to connect two things first. Obviously, our power, as well as a network cable. This could be connected to your local area network, or even directly to a computer. Once we have those connected, we need to figure out how to find Pearl on the network. There are a couple of ways the Pearl gets an IP address, either manually static assigned or through DHCP, an automatic address. This one I've configured for static address, but I'll show you how we can find out the DHCP address as well. On the front touchscreen of Pearl 2 is where we can find a lot of information about the networking. So let's take a look at the front touchscreen. From the front touchscreen of Pearl, when it first boots up, we'll see quick information about our channels that are currently configured. Out of the box, you'll see Auto A and Auto B. How we can change those settings, you'll see in other videos about Pearl. On the front touchscreen, there's a variety of buttons that will appear along the bottom edge. One of them is this little gear icon that brings us into the settings menu. At the very top, you'll see network settings, and we can use this to change a static IP address or move between static IP and DHCP mode. If we're using Pearl in a DHCP environment, we can find out the assigned IP address by looking at the system status, and it will be displayed here. In some scenarios, you may need to know the MAC address of Pearl in order to get access to your network. That can also be found here on this screen. If we do need to assign a static IP address, we can go into that menu, as I did earlier, and we can assign the IP address, the subnet mask, the default gateway, and the DNS server. When setting a static IP address, all four fields do need to be populated. Once we know the IP address of our Pearl, it's quite easy to then look at connecting directly to it. To do that, we would use a web browser on a computer, a tablet, or a smartphone. Let's take a look at connecting to Pearl using a web browser on a laptop. Here on my laptop, I have Google Chrome installed, and all I need to do now that I know the IP address of my Pearl is enter that into the address bar, and it will bring up the Pearl interface. If a login prompt appears, enter the correct username and password, and you will get full access to Pearl. Here I've logged in as administrator, and I now have access to all of the settings within Pearl. For starters, we may want to look at configuring one of our automatic channels for our particular needs, looking at encoding settings, streaming settings, and even recording settings. We have other videos covering these topics. If we need to make changes to the network settings, we can also do that through this web browser interface as well, if the situation changes. That's a quick overview of getting network connectivity and access to your Pearl 2. Be sure to like and subscribe to this video. Of course, check out all of our other videos talking about Pearl 2 and its various configurations you can do. If you have any questions, always reach out to us at Epiphan Video. Thank you.